Welcome to the Stanley Cup Final, presented by GEICO. Tonight, it's game one of the best of seven, the St. Louis Blues and the Boston Bruins.
Fourth line versus fourth line. Heavy players against heavy players. The large captains on defense are starting. Craig Berube, the Blues coach, said, "We will be direct, and I expect they, the Bruins, will be too." And at the very start, tumbling down was Sean Corrali, and he comes back with a brush check against Oscar Sundquist, and the puck out of play at the calm of the Blues bench. Then in close quarters for Schenk. Tarasenko taken out of the play by the captain Zdeno Chara, and then it's held by Schenk. Schenk fired one, kicked back out again by Raff. Rebound, bounced one back. Schenk is up, he scores! 1-0 in favor of the Blues on Braden Schenk's goal.
He was cold as ice in terms of scoring, but he's been a fantastic player for the St. Louis Blues. He scored in game six, and here he gets the icebreaker in game one of the Stanley Cup Final. Great joust on the boards. Bergeron can't get it out. A nice job by Schenk to keep it alive. Throw it on goal. Chunky rebound going to come right out front off the stick of Schwartz, and you see Braden Schenk just jump on it and go high blocker.
Jay Bouwmeester makes this play. Again, we talked about the active defense for both teams. Watch Bouwmeester. Look at him anticipating that the puck is going to be there offensively. He hangs around, keeps the play alive. And then Schenk goes far side on Tuukka Rask, who was a little deep in his net. He has been very aggressive in these playoffs. Usually you see him out on top of the blue paint. But after a terrific start for the Bruins, the Blues cash in on their first best chance of the game.
With Pasternak stepping into Parayko. Meanwhile, this is Steen again. Now a Sundquist shot blocked away by Tuukka Rask. The Boston Bruins power play that has been lights out in these playoffs. Delayed call on. Marchand able to dish it back. Gets the return from Torrey Krug. Marchand swept it back to Krug and a shot. That one kicked back out by the defense but not controlled. Turned along but spiked away from Bogey. Around behind it is played in front by Pasternak.
Pasternak stole the puck, he wrapped it around, looking for Johansson on the weak side, and Bouwmeester with a great stick-on-stick play.
Weechy able to hand it across, escaping now, Johansson around, hit the post with a shot, Tyler shot, and that bounced off of the defense of Gunnarsson.
Well, Johansson does a great job of going right through the defense of the Blues. As Bennington's going down, he elevates and just hits that far post. Can't hit it any more square than that.
What a scamper by Johansson to get through the Blues defense, up and over the glove. Something the Blues are going to have to be better at in the second and third period of game one.
Pearson down low, what, because of size? Or no, we have a giveaway here, and a feed on front score! Tarasenko! And it's 2-0! Just about the time you think everything is safe back there, it is a steal and a score, and the Blues are up by a pair.
Well, Charlie McAvoy thinks that Zdeno Chara is going to come back. They try to reverse this puck. Now watch what happens. This is David Pasternak. He thinks he's going to throw it back to Zdeno Chara. And he gives it right to Schenk. And Schenk gives it to Tarasenko, and Rask gets beat to that stick side again. But that was a forward back in Pasternak. Trying to reverse the flow, and Chara didn't read it. And Pasternak turned it over, and the right guy had the puck on the stick for the St. Louis Blues, and now they have a 2-0 lead.
But he was defended away. Bruins accelerate ahead. It's brought on by Corrali. Corrali moves up with a Chara. Hold. Pick one in front. Score! Off of Binnington. Tipped in. And it is 2-1. Clifton collects the goal out of what seemed like a broken play that had no chance, and then it did, and it wound up going off the netminder's stick.
Well, the fourth line of the Boston Bruins generating. Clifton looking for the blue paint, and Corrali finds Clifton, the defenseman, jumping into the play with Bortuzzo there, and Binnington out. And the Bruins get a huge response from their fourth goal and getting a defenseman involved as well.
Boy, the speed of Sean Corrali, back for Tuzo and Gunnarsson right off the blue line. And that created all that time and space for Corrali to make the cross-crease feed over to Connor Clifton.
Just a minute 16 after the Blues had a 2-0 lead. It is 2-1, but there is conversation. And it is a good goal. All goals reviewed. McAvoy hands it on. Johansson trying to connect one in front of the ricochet. Around the corner, Stanton behind. And Binnington back to his feet without his goal stick. Meanwhile, they battle for it. It comes back out the center. He regains his goal stick. Not a shot on goal yet. Walk back in. McAvoy, a shot.
The puck goes off of the stick, I believe, of Alex Pietrangelo. And that's your conventional power play goal. And the reaction from Jordan Binnington, this game is tied up at two.
They couldn't get a left-handed defenseman on the ice, and it did go off Pietrangelo's stick.
Watching tonight, there's a strong shot by Carlo that's turned aside by Binnington.
Boston's done a good job off a face-off win, face-off plays.
Coyle around behind, Johansson flips to him. Coyle tried to turn and let a shot go, and O'Reilly wouldn't let that happen cleanly. Played on by Achari, and then Corrali wants to play the point. Chara flips one, then shrug down off of Binnington. Strathboy there, stays in front, Corrali scores!
Clifton started the offense. Puck to the net. Second chance opportunity. Corrali finds a loose puck, and you see the reaction from Edmondson. Clifton reads it. Now the Bruins get some fresh players on the ice, and the fourth liners go to work.
What a game for Connor Clifton. Not signed by the original team that drafted him. He scored the icebreaker here for the Bruins. Just got a big assist. And look at them, the Lambeau leap for Sean Corrali, who's got a flair for the dramatic, going back to earlier this year at the outdoor game, the Winter Classic, scoring a winner for the Bruins. And the night before that, or two nights before that in Buffalo.
Edmondson had his back to the puck. He wasn't sure where the puck was. Achari just throws it to the front of the net. And Corrali's facing the play, stick down. Binnington wasn't able to move right to left. And the Bruins have come all the way back from being down 2-0 and off for one goal lead.
Ivan able to gain the zone, has Krejci nearby. A couple of players tangle at the other end. Meanwhile, around behind it, Krejci holding on to it, put it to the slot, and a shot by McAvoy is deflected wide. Thomas is cracking it with a running lead over one of the first Thomas, and the shot is held by Binnington, and there's chaos all around, and the fans are standing and applauding all of the action here.
Krug was the one that was battling with Perron. Perron popped his helmet off, and then Krug jumped into the play, and then popped Robert Thomas. Watch the battle in front of the net. As you mentioned, Doc, two players in behind. Krug and Perron sticks up, backing, whacking, clutching, grabbing, pulling, popping, and that Krug jumps into the play, and a good, clean, hard hit. Never left his feet after he made the contact. You can see the reaction from the Bruins bench.
Marchand able to step by one. Marchand slipped one that's whacking just wide and can be forced along there by Perron. Then Perron high. Marchand scores! Final seconds go off. And a tremendous start for the Boston Bruins. One last save and a scramble by Rask. The clock shows zeros. Rask is helmetless, but unbound because his team has won game number one.
Boy, Tuukka Rask made a great save. I believe off of Braden Schenn standing in front of the net. Schenn with an outstanding game, a goal and assist in this game one of the Stanley Cup Final.
It is a celebratory song tonight because they have come from 2-0 down to win this game by a score of 4-2. No changes for Boston for the Blues. Forward Robert Thomas out, Robbie Fabry in after being scratched the last eight. And the big guns offensively start for both teams. Coast in, Bergeron there, the first face-off of game number two. Flip one back down that went into Barbashev, but he gets it established anyway, and then back down comes Pastrnak. Pastrnak fed it on across, Jake DeBrusk able to wheel in.
What a pass by DeBrusk and a one-time finish from a strong side. 1-0 Boston.
Look at this area of the ice. The Bruins are going for a change. It's 2-4. And Pastrnak gets it to DeBrusk and Charlie Coyle comes right down Main Street. No hesitation at all. Right off the heel of the stick of Binnington. I would say that is a soft goal. You've got to get a stop. It was a quick release. But that's one where you got to get a save. But heck of a play by DeBrusk to get it to Coyle. No hesitation. And a 1-0 lead. Power play goal for the Bruins.
Schwartz up with it once more from Maroon. Got it back to Edmondson. Edmondson off the boards wide. Dug out by Maroon. And he put it on goal. And a save made there by Rask. Ozak deals it around behind. They're getting zone time for sure. Around behind it comes now for Maroon. Fed in front and unable to get a shot out of that. Was Bozak on back to board Kuzo now. Hands back over to Gunnarsson. Gunnarsson off the boards with a pass attempt. Fed across there by Bozak. Then Bortuzzo score! And the game is tied!
What a shift for Pat Maroon. I mean, this was an extended shift. Defenseman pressing in. Getting pucks to the net. Bortuzzo throws his puck. Rask down. Maybe off of Grizzlick in front. It changes direction. Maybe even Maroon. But the hard work and shift. And off the knee of Grizzlick in front. Changes direction. And beats Tuukka Rask to the short side, but what a shift by Pat Maroon.
Started that shift playing with Schenn and Schwartz because Tarasenko came off. And what a goal by Bortuzzo, the hero of game two in the San Jose series. He scored the highlight reel goal, a game winner in that game. Now he's got his team tied up here in game two.
Gathered in there, but turned right over to Nordstrom by Perron, and then thrown right back to Perron. Dropped one off the boards, and it's reversed around behind, but getting to that quickly, feeding in front.
Breakdown defensively, and the patience of Joakim Nordstrom. forehand, backhand, right between the legs of Jordan Binnington.
Off the right skate to the stick. The wickets are opened up, and it's 2-1 Boston. Great forecheck play, and the depth guys come through again, led by Corrali.
All right, that turnover by David Perron. That puck has got to get out when you're 10, 15 feet inside your own blue line.
Went off of Pasternak, tried to play the point, but it came right ahead for Tarasenko. And ahead now to Schwartz, who moves in. Oh, rebound! Oh, and it wouldn't go! Rebound, they score! Tarasenko, and it's 2-2.
Really good puck movement by the St. Louis Blues. We talked about it. Foot race ensues. Tarasenko moves to Schwartz. He's stressed. Stanley Chara good shot on goal. Chara stops the first one, but he can't stop the backhand by Tarasenko. Tarasenko never quit on this play. Eventually just stays with it and roofs the backhand up and over.
Watch Tarasenko. He's over in this area here. Watch Brad Marchand. This is a two-on-two. He comes over. Now all of a sudden it becomes a two-on-one. Beautiful backhand pass. Schwartz with the shot. Second chance opportunity. First one was stopped by Chara, and then he stays with that second opportunity. But again, once Marchand went at Tarasenko, he's either got to get the puck or the man. He got neither. And then that was a two-on-one from the red line in, and Tarasenko is absolutely red hot the entirety of that last shift.
Oh, Grizzlick run into there by Sundqvist. Meanwhile, the puck comes out in front, but Grizzlick is down, and there'll be a penalty coming up here.
Sundqvist, he's the one that made contact with Grizzlick. Looked like Grizzlick changed his level a bit, Doc, as he was going back for the puck. But it's that situation when you're going back, and when you watch it in real speed, you see that. Look, he's trying to fake out Sundqvist. He opens up. Looks like he's going to go one way, and then he fires it back the other way. And he puts himself in a tough spot, and that's where the contact comes up. So hopefully Grizzlick is okay.
Brought back ahead and dished off that time. And can be held by Shannon. A shot struck down and then covered by the netminder Rask.
Of a play, Doc, defensively by Bortuzzo.
Great recovery after the turnover.
Around behind his coil. Good one around in front. Backhand to play. Heinen is pulled off and then covered by Binnington. Sent back on by Chara. Poked back across by Johansson. And Perron, a shot saved. Made there by Rask.
Ran into a man in this league from David Backus, and he says thank you very much.
It was an active shift there, Pierre, for David Backus.
More battling on the boards. It's twisted back by Corrali, handed on over to McAvoy. McAvoy, a shot caught off by Binnington. Rebound! And he stopped that one too. And a scramble, but the whistle is blown. Thrown along by Petrangelo, came along to Sundqvist. Led back over for a shot that ricocheted off the frame. And that one came from Steen. Then over to Perron. To Parayko with a shot. Left blocked away and shaken up on the play as Nordstrom. One good leg. Now Parayko again. His shot wouldn't get through. They try to work something side of the net. That didn't pan out. It went away from Maroon. Pinching back in is Perron. Rush check there by Corrali. Back to Parayko and his shot. Hit Nordstrom again.
Goal score in the first period. Shot blocking machine here in the second period. That one buckled him back as you picked up on. This one's selling out the right leg. Two with the body, one with the stick. Taps all around as he went to the bench. Shot block.
A diving play by McAvoy, and now it is thrown off by Marchand. Moving up with Bergeron. Marchand hole. Fed it across, and it bounced off one of the Blues in front. Pass is knifed down and brought back in by Tarasenko onside. Tarasenko, a shot fall off. Rebound out in front, directed away, anticipating that, but the dive was red. The brush hands on to Marchand. Flipped it in front. Oh, and a turnaround backhander wouldn't get through for DeBrun. Taken along to the outside by Pasternak. Sent on to Krug. Krug a shot, and it went wide. And Kareem back down. This one is off of Nordstrom and yanked on back. It's an onside play. And looking and playing it to Maroon. Oh, and a great save made by Rask on Maroon. Who had him dead to rights again. And the loose puck came along, and then Shen has it. Bed one that's poked away. Sundqvist set up at the opposite circle. Across the gunner, Simmershot, he scores! a straight puck, kicking it along and saving it as a souvenir for Gunnarsson, who has staked his team to an even spot in this series, going back home to St. Louis.
Well, remember, there was a delayed call coming up against the Bruins. So they had the extra attacker, the screen by Alex Pietrangelo, right in the wheelhouse of Carl Gunnarsson. No chance for Rask to see that shot. Beautiful pass from Ryan O'Reilly. He goes top shelf. Look at the screen by Pietrangelo. No chance for Rask. Heavy shot, and the reaction from the Blues. And I'm sure they're jumping for joy in St. Louis right now, getting ready to welcome their team home for Game 3 on Saturday night, tied up at 1.
Through the first two games in a change of venue in St. Louis. Sure glad you're here with us. Bergeron to take the first draw with Shen. Blues control. Parayko there. And back in. And an icing 7 seconds in. Sent one that popped to the corner off a Blues stick. And then a big hit has sent David Backus, the ex-Blue, down to the ice from Sammy Blais. That one careened just by him. Blais able to get out to center. Here's McAvoy twisting it back. Marshall giving it to a Foster. Look at shot. And a tap by Binnington.
Bergeron spot. During that shift, but what a pass and what a save by Jordan Binnington. Somehow, someway, going left to right off the one-timer. The Bruins do everything exactly the way you want in setting up an offensive play. And Binnington makes a stop. A lot of room up top. Pasternak trying to go low. And Binnington makes a huge save, but a building block there for that big line of the Bruins.
Sent to the back by DeBrusk, walked over by Krug, and a shot, he scores! A deflection en route. Bergeron has tipped it in, and it is a 1-0 lead for the Bruins, and for the seventh straight game, they have a power play goal.
In the first two games of the Stanley Cup Final, Doc, it wasn't your conventional power play. You guys shooting the puck, but there's that beautiful pass from Torrey Krug. Face-off win for Bergeron. Krug shoots for the stick, and this puck goes right past the glove of Jordan Binnington. So again, the Bruins worked on their power play yesterday in practice. Wanted to have the mindset, as we talked about in the first two games of the series, just don't turn down opportunities to get the puck to the net, and no chance for the Blues goaltender.
Just love the support for Bergeron, that faceoff win. It takes more than one guy to win faceoffs. Jake DeBrusk did a great job getting that puck back to the point for the Bruins.
McAvoy, who's able to sashay from front. That's back one now for Pasternak. Oh, and now to the ice was Shen. Pasternak seems to be fine in that collision. Sit down was O'Reilly. Puck started ahead now, trying to find his way free as Coyle. Able to get to center and then one to Dan Heinen. Heinen drops, Johansson across, Coyle, score! Charlie Coyle! And it's 2-0.
Watch the work by 13 and right below the goal line. He's helping out McAvoy. Look at the stick. And now he avoids the hit by Sammy Blais. Now it's a 3-on-2. Heinen to Johansson, that great chemistry with Johansson and Coyle. No chance for Binnington. Great defense leads the offense.
Well, defensive pairings that aren't normal. Benderson was playing on the right. Bo Meester was on the left. They both had different partners. They were not comfortable. They didn't defend the rush well. And Charlie Coyle makes them pay.
Executed play by Johansson and Coyle.
Corrali, a shot, he scores! Sean Corrali, and it's 3-0.
Right here, and then Corrali gets it. He fires it right between the legs of Pietrangelo, right past Jordan Binnington. The quick release, and a huge goal for the Boston Bruins. And a tough goal to give up if you're Jordan Binnington and the St. Louis Blues.
That's 3 5-hole goals in the last two games against Binnington.
St. Louis is challenging the play. to determine if there was offside prior to the goal.
Wow. John Farrell is a video coach for the St. Louis Blues. He's breaking that down. This is the angle where I said it looks like it's offside.
After review, it's determined that the play was onside. The call on the ice stands. We have a goal. St. Louis has assessed a bench minor penalty.
Marchand tried to poke it back to the point. No luck. Barbashev in the way, but now it's Bergeron whipping it across. He curved around in front. Pasternak, he scores! What a backhand by Pasternak! And it's 4-0.
We showed Pasternak with a one-time opportunity in the first period. He didn't get good wit on it. He got good wit on this one. Bergeron, subtle little play across the blue line, and then Pasternak with the backhand up and over Jordan Binnington. He made that one look easy, Eddie.
All by himself. But a breakdown defensively for the Blues. Here's the goal scorer, right? Watch the Blues. Pursuit, pursuit. And then now they leave this area of the ice wide open. Watch this. Wide open in front. Slow to react. Pasternak, quick little shovel. And then the backhand up top over Binnington. Set it up. Pressure, penalty kill. Change sides, relieve the pressure. And they are up 4-0 now. Not going to get two or three in one shift. That's the mindset. You just got to get the next one.
Force around in front. Maroon with a backhander that was wide. Along to play it is Bergeron. Guided it back to Carlo. Carlo side of the net now. Pasternak, a shot that's blocked off by Binnington. Rebound! And Binnington got a piece of that, and then it's nudged right into him. And he will hold on, and play is stopped. Tarasenko able to drift behind him. That went off Bozak. Or Parayko, who can hand it across to Perron. Then on to Bozak, and a save made by Raskin. A strong shot. Steen there. Threw it back out. Petrangelo drifting. Gave it back to Barbashev. And a shot off the high off of Heinen. Played on by Steen again. Then it's Zach Sanford. Shouldered there by Chara. Rolled off. That one in front. Score! It's Barbashev. 4-1.
Now the grinding guys go to work. Zach Sanford's going to get his first ever NHL playoff point. Keeping plays alive, getting it down low. The strength of the Blues, the cycle. Here's Zach Sanford spinning off. Does that go off Charlie McAvoy? It doesn't matter. Barbashev's going to get the goal. Quick release off the skate of McAvoy. It elevates Pat Tsukaras. 4-1 Boston leads. But for Zach Sanford, smart, hard play. He gets rewarded with an assist.
How about Sanford shaking off Zdeno Chara below the goal line? That allowed separation, the quick little backhand, double deflection, off the right skate, off the left skate, into the back of the net. And the Blues got some life. Their fourth line cashes in.
To poke it back. Fed back on to Bergeron, across down to Marchand. Trying to get it in front, but Bomeister blocked that. And it is retrieved by Krug, Podesta on to Marchand. Podesta right through to Krug, and here's Krug's shot. He scores! Krug, and it's 3-3 on the power play.
If you're Craig Berube, you got to be thinking about getting Jake Allen into this game. I think this is one that Binnington needs to have. It's from well out, little bit of a screen. Yes, it was deflected. And Binnington gets beat on the short side. And it hits his glove.
They listen to you, Eddie. Here comes a change.
For the first time in these playoffs, Jordan Binnington will not be in the goal crease. It will be Jake Allen.
Doc, we talked about the Bruins' power play in the first two games in Boston.
Inadvertently, so play continues. Here's Sammy Blay laying it in. It's run by O'Reilly. O'Reilly holds. Another shot. Goal. It's off the crossbar.
He couldn't get the rebound to go, but man, Tukarask is on it.
0-for-3 on the power play with 6 shots. Parayko, a shot. Score! Deflected on rim. And it is 5-2. And finally, the Blues get a
LaPierre made mention a little bit earlier on that 4-on-3 that the Blues were trying to isolate Colton Parayko for the big one-timer. Weren't able to do it on the 4-on-3, but they were able to do it on the 5-on-4. And you mentioned, Doc, this thing goes deflected. It ends up going in and off of Carlo past Tuukka Rask.
That thing is launched, and there's a deflection that Eddie talked about off the midsection of Brandon Carlo, 5-2. St. Louis still 3 goals down.
The puck was going way wide. But again, you just never know when you get it towards the blue paint.
That was not a good penalty for Zdeno Chara to take, and he knows it.
90 to go in the tilt. Shoved on back to Krug, across for a drive, score! Johansson! The Bruins with yet another power play goal, and it is 7-2.
That's some pretty slick puck movement, Eddie.
Four shots on four power plays and four goals. No wasted motion by these guys.
Johansson's going to move the puck over to Krug. Krug's going to return the favor with the no-look slap pass, and then the one-timer for Johansson just beats Jake Allen short side.
Early in this game, when it was very close, Tuukka Rask again was strong. That is it, and the Bruins have surgically and decisively taken a lead in the series, 2-1, with a 7-2 win tonight in St. Louis.
Game 4, Doc.
You saw Oscar Sundquist close up. He is back from suspension. Robbie Fabry comes out. The fourth line of the Blues starts against the first line of the Bruins, the scoring prominent line, the perfection line. There for a wrister by Vince Dunn that is sent away right for an extra and it is O'Reilly 1-0. Tuukka Rask makes a great save right before this goal. Shot from the point, redirected by Sanford, and then the wraparound from Ryan O'Reilly. O'Reilly won the faceoff to start the whole play, and Rask not able to reach over with that left leg.
You love how quick Vince Dunn put that puck on goal. Yeah, it's going crazy like a knuckleball. And Ryan O'Reilly, who had a real tough game number 3, shows up to start for game 4 here.
And rolled on around, but right to Parayko, who keeps play moving for St. Louis. Parayko able to step away, got it on the Sanford, and shot, scrambled in front there, but the puck is underneath to Rask.
Good idea there from Sanford just to get the puck to the net. If you're the Blues right now, you want to skate away from any of this.
A little trouble with the inadvertent checking of the linesman, and so it's turned over to the Bruins for a toss back in and around by Charlie Coyle. Puck came loose, fed out in front, oh, and Johansson with a shot that went wide. Curled on back now, Bomeister rushes back in. Bomeister head up, works it along the Sundquist, behind the Bomeister. Head one on out, and a shot by Barbashev is followed off by Rask. Popping it to the corner, moving in is Carlo, after him Sanford, they cross up. Sanford nudged it around behind. Tucked out in front, here's Perron, tied it back in, run off of Rask. Well, slid back out by Sanford, but it's directed back by Krejci, and again McAvoy connects with Chara, slides one on ahead to Heinen. Heinen alone right now, but his team is changing. Regathers reinforcements, and now it's Chara marching on, and a shot saved. Rebound, score! And it's Charlie Coyle! And the game is tied!
Charlie Coyle's as hot as any player in the Stanley Cup Final. Benton Heinen's going to take a hit to make a play. Shen comes in, lowers the boom. They keep the play alive. Charlie Coyle going hanging out the corner into the front of the net, and he does. It'll take that Chara shot and put it by Jordan Binnington to tie the game up.
Second chance opportunity. Binnington makes a good save off the initial shot from Chara that is redirected by Coyle, but a quick little push. Get it past the left leg. And Charlie Coyle ties this game up.
Here's Marchand, able to enter the zone, puts on the brakes, and nudged one back. Carlo, a shot, and that grab by but his shot was from outside the line.
Heinen got it across, but that one was slowed down enough by Parayko that it is Blaine slipping it further, and then it's brought back one now for Brady Shen. Shen dropped one further. It came all the way back now for Congratulations.
Well, Pierre mentioned it. Jaden Schwartz here. Looks like Clifton's going to get it, but not so fast. Petrangelo's second chance opportunity. And Tarasenko puts it to the back of the net.
Shots on goal in this period already, all from the Bruins. As here's a shot by Shen. Oh, and that fouled Tara, who is down.
Right off his stick, it ramped up right into his face. Shen with the release. Chara turned the puck over. Shen on the attack. And that got him up high and hard off his own stick. And you see, he's leaking. He will need major repairs. Donnie Del Negro getting him right off the ice. Chara tried to move the puck through the middle. Shen intercepted. Watch it ramp right off his stick and right up into the face of Chara. Yeah, the last time the Bruins went down to five defensemen, Eddie and Doc, was game two. That's when Matt Grizzlick got knocked out by Sundqvist. You know what happens when they're down to five, they just get more physical.
Angled on back, tapped away from Krug, carried up by O'Reilly. O'Reilly and a good ball off there. Circle to the outside, gives back one to Parayko, then across it comes to O'Reilly. Binnington! My goodness! Ahead now, Marchand. Marchand delays. Gets it on now to Bergeron. Bergeron, a shot saved. Rebound. Carlo scores! A shorthanded goal! And for Carlo, it's his first ever goal in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and it ties the game.
Two outstanding plays by the Bruins. Marchand buys some time. Now he flips his puck up, and then Bergeron hand to it. Stick, big rebound, and Carlo jumps into the play.
Watch where they
beautiful
shoot.
Play here all the way around.
Hey, watch where Bergeron shoots. He's shooting five hole right there. That creates a juicy rebound for Brandon Carlo, and he just jumps in and snaps it off the glove.
Good read by Carlo, too, to be able to jump into that play, recognizing there might be an opportunity to create some offense.
Tarasenko delays and pulls and shoots one. Knocked loose in front. And out of position because he had made the initial save was Rask, but the puck kicked across and could be cleared. Across now, Tarasenko dropped it off now to Schwartz. Schwartz for Tarasenko. Big one in front. O'Reilly couldn't get it inside away. Schwartz couldn't either. Then Parayko walks it back across. Got another drive. Save made by Rask. Rebound and Rask went down and covered. And responsibilities in this game. Brought back on by Petrangelo. Fires. Struck away. Rebound. Scores! It is O'Reilly. It's 3-2.
We've talked all series long of how active the Blues defensemen are. Shot, rebound, and Ryan O'Reilly with his second here in game four. See Petrangelo, he's looking to see where the help is coming from. A tough shot to control your rebound. It goes right into the slot, and O'Reilly buries it.
What a
this series. What a shot by Petrangelo.
Perron chased off, still able to get it back for a shot by Parayko, but it's sealed up by Rask, a scorching shot. Able to play this now is Connor Clifton. 1:35 left. Clifton able to motor back out to center. Had it knocked away. It's brought back on by Shen. He's got it! Squirreled all the way out. All over but the shouting. We'll let you hear it. The best players out there for the start of the game. Hunter Clifton brings it on. Slides it on now for the play by Charlie Coyle. Then on for Johansson. Johansson able to scoot around behind and shuffle one in front. Battle for there. And a scramble still before the whistle is blown. And the puck eventually corralled by Jordan Binnington. Back down at center and curled around by McAvoy. McAvoy wants to recoil and get back in, which he does. It's across to Marchand, and a shot through the top. Rebound! That hits someone in front. Some good thrust by both teams here. The collision at center is down with Petrangelo on the collision with Achari.
He's not feeling very good. He got hit up high.
Had something to say to the referee. Meanwhile, Barbashev there. Sent one around in front. That one ricocheted on the Plainen, who was watching in front for the Bruins. Into him by Achari. So it ricochets for McAvoy to scale the other way. Tipped back out by Nordstrom. Slowed down off the linesman's skate. Picked up there by Corrali. And Corrali moves. And someone on goal. Rebound kicked on across. And it can be played back by Schwartz. The Bruins are 6 out of 16 in this series. But we're empty in the last game. Here comes Marchand, a shot high on the Binnington. Rebound tipped around now, and Sundqvist is able to clear. Sent it around behind for Johansson to connect back to McAvoy. McAvoy sent it there, North Cross again. Here's Krejci side of the net now for Krugenbrecht. Oh, and a shot there by Coyle. Was turned aside by Binnington, and it's floated along, and it bounces on back to be taken by McAvoy. Led on to the back to Gunnarsson, then on across again for Petrangelo, and that shot ricocheted off the falling center, and then another try from another Bruin defender, and that was Carlo, and maybe Rask got a piece of it. Parayko with a shot, and that blocked down. Outlet it ahead, and moving on in is Marchand. Marchand able to pivot with it now, got it on the front foot to Pasternak, and a shot to save that time by Binnington. Grabbed off now and started back out for the play by DeBrusk. Hands it back over, and here is a feed on across, and Carlo shot, and that save is made by Binnington. Across it's taken by Bomeister, led on to Schwartz again. Schwartz sees this one go back to Bomeister, save made by Rask. Most of the time, Shen shoved off by Bergeron. Bergeron got it on. A shot rang off the pipe from Marchand on a beautiful feed. The production line, the big one, the perfect line, they call them, trying to do that. And another shot that time from Bergeron was high on Binnington. Run into by DeBrusk. Nudged ahead, but errantly, that time by Petrangelo. Here's Krejci feeding it across. Drive! And that one blocked away by Binnington on a hard drive from Pasternak. Shovels off to O'Reilly, has Tarasenko nearby. Across Perron. Oh, and a save made by Rask.
Only 6 shots in this first period for the Blues. Right side of your screen, and Rask somehow finds this puck.
And a pass by O'Reilly, and the response that Eddie's talking about from Tuukka Rask.
And then it's popped on back, and Schwartz is able to step in. Fires, and that one got the glass. And around now, it is battled for by Perron, and onto the back. Sent around behind Zach Sanford there. That one in front! Score! The Blues have connected. It's Ryan O'Reilly on a feed from Sanford, and it's 1-0.
Ryan O'Reilly smoking hot, his third goal in three and two games. But how about Zach Sanford? Put on this line before game four. This is his third assist in three games. Threw the legs out front. Patient from O'Reilly. He puts it up and over Charlie McAvoy. And look at that play by O'Reilly. What a spectacular finish off the feed by Sanford.
Once you have a goaltender down, you got to move the puck laterally. And that's what O'Reilly does. Forehand, backhand, shovel over the glove. Great cycle. Let's not forget the opportunity Tarasenko had right before that.
Eventually, Blaze is sent down to the ice into the corner. The puck wound up underneath him for a moment on the hit by a Turing. Then to the back it comes, and Carlo shot directed right into Binnington by Atari, and he's able to save it. For a play to be made by Marchand, but it was not. O'Reilly able to feed one on to Pareko, then given back out by Sanford. Hustling ahead is Perron. He's got O'Reilly breaking. Save made by Raskin. The rebound is able to cover and hang on. Petrangelo watches as Dunn is there. Run off with authority by Corrali. Oh, and then stepping in heavily to Achari. That time was Shin. Here's Chara's shot, and that wouldn't find its way through. Around behind Achari, got it onto Corrali. Corrali with a shot high off Binnington. Onto the back it comes again. McAvoy a shot, and that went off a stick and went wide. Multiple overtimes are not unusual in any round of the Stanley Cup playoffs. This is thrown out in front, and twisting shot would not work for Johansson.
Real nice rebound control from Binnington.
Handed across Kemp for a shot, and that one is saved by Binnington, and it's cleared back down.
Five on five, haven't been involved as much here in the second period. Now McAvoy gets the puck below the goal line here in the second.
To the back it comes to Kruger, shot off the boards, came right back out to the slot, and is pitched back out. Rust moves in on Gunnarsson, puck up for grabs, poked back into the pile by Bomeister, and then swung onto the back now for McAvoy with a shot that would not go. Able to escape partly, and then nudged it on and came right back to him. Still trying to get possession, and then he ties up with Sengler. Meanwhile, it's Maroon to the slot, and turning along and shooting one out. What a spotted save was made there by Krejci on Petrangelo. And it's Maroon off the back of the cage. 2 seconds and one, and the Bruins fans are very upset that there was no penalty call made. But Krejci made the save that kept this from being 2-0.
Well, the mishandle by Tori Krugan, and he got tied up with Oscar Sundquist. And then Maroon makes the play. The left part of your screen, Alex Petrangelo. There's everything you want. Wait, wait, wait. He's got an empty net. And David Krejci slides in and saves the day with a left arm save and a beauty. With Rask down and out. Remember that stop by David Krejci.
Little over 9.5 to go in regulation time. Oh, and there's Bozak, and clipping down to the ice and shaking up on the play. Slow to get up is Achari. Meanwhile, it is Perron trying to feed one in front. They score! It is Perron who has gotten the second goal of the game. Achari shaken up. Of all of the confusion down on the ice, fans are throwing stuff on the ice now and are being shown a replay of Achari tumbling down.
Well, Bozak takes the legs out from under Noel Achari,
and he turns back and looks back at the referee. Play continues, and then it is the scoring of the goal.
Unfortunate bounce for David Perron. This puck goes in, goes off of Tori Krug. It goes right back to him and then off the pad of Tuukka Rask. Again, the reason that the official did not blow the play dead is because St. Louis had possession of the puck in the offensive zone. So even though Achari was shaken up, the play continued because the Blues had possession. And Achari just barely got to his knees, and the puck ended up in the back of the net. Right now, just making the game just way too difficult. Sundquist going to get a penalty here.
Krug across in the back. Score! It's DeBrusk on the delayed call to make it 2-1.
Trying to see if Tori Krug is bleeding here. If it's only a 2-minute penalty, then there would be no penalty. They scored with the delayed call, but if there is, It could go on the power play, but it's only going to be a two-minute penalty. But Jake DeBrusk on the board after Tory Krug takes a high stick from Oscar Sundquist. Defenseman getting involved, taking a chance. Krug stays with it, and then puts it right in the wheelhouse of Jake DeBrusk. And now the Bruins have life and some momentum. And obviously, with the way things have transpired here, you think about the no call, the trip on Achari, and then Perron shortly after that puts the puck in the back of the net. But here we are at 2-1. One again by Bergeron, held to the back. Great chance shot, ball up there, picked up now by Steen. 1 second, and the Blues have the lead. 3-2, winning the contest by a score of 2-1. And more debris rains down here in Boston. O'Reilly's line against Boston's fourth line. Chara, McAvoy, Gunnarsson, Petrangelo. The two captains out there for the start of game number six. Some trouble at the half boards for the Bruins, and turning away is Krug. That one is picked right out in front, and a save is made by Rask, but a turnover and a chance for Bozak. 1-14. And in this critical game six for them, Bozak threw on in front, and got all the way through and was set aside off of Rask and then left it back out. Back down to Perron, then handed across. Perron up with it again, got it unbacked. Done it, shot, fall off and got rebound. Oh, and that one didn't get through. A sprawling play in front, it hit someone. Played back along now for Dunn again. Hurries it around behind it, curls back up now to Perron. Perron just looks over the traffic. Moving on inside of the net play for Schwartz. He's chased off there by Moore. Now Perron a shot. Save and a cover by Rask.
Braden Schenn with an A-plus save and Tuukka Rask with a right leg pad save and a beauty. Simple play by the Blues. Get the pucks to the net, shrink the numbers in front, and Tuukka Rask, watch the right leg. Schenn gets it, pulls it, and what a stop by Rask. Schenn just not able to elevate that puck.
Gunnarsson up with it there, the hero of game number two with the overtime winner. Around it is taken then by Perron, rolled around behind. Sanford stood up gently to the board by McAvoy. It came back up, Perron, a rising shot, and that ricocheted off Rask, and then popped to the glass.
For them, Doc, it's all about simplifying, taking the lanes that are given, and shooting the puck. Don't turn down those opportunities.
Moving back is Pastrnak against it. Pastrnak gives it across. 5-1-3 for the Bruins. They haven't had one yet until now. Pastrnak holds, deals it back off to Krejci. Looks, gives it back to Pastrnak across. Kruger shot, save, Binnington. Rebounds, Binnington, back to Krug. Across to Pastrnak again. Pastrnak sent it across. Score! What a shot by Marchand! And it is 1-0 in favor of the Bruins, and they still have a minute 39 on the second penalty.
What a pass by David Pastrnak, but the release by Marchand is a thing of beauty. If he stops this puck, it allows the goaltender to move all the way over and get in position, but he shoots it right off the pass and elevates it up and over the glove of Jordan Binnington.
If you ever watch the Bruins in a pregame skate, Marchand and Krejci work on that all the time, and it's Krejci passing to Marchand. Marchand doesn't miss very often from there on the one-timer.
Here is DeBrusk off the face-off, and that shot blocked down. Rebound, another try, and Binnington has that from Krejci, who throws his head back.
That's a big moment right there for Jordan Binnington and the St. Louis Blues. Doc's talked about Krejci kind of being a little bit cold. There's a chance for DeBrusk. Great shot block by Bortuzzo. And Krejci just reloads, puts it in, and Binnington says, I'm not giving up a rebound. So pretty good rebound control and a little fortuitous. DeBrusk actually touches that. So from that angle, a little different. DeBrusk helped Binnington out there big time.
Along to get it, Vince Dunn fired one around that came right freely to center, brought on by Maroon, handed back over to Bozak, right around in front, Maroon steered it wide. Oh, and then Dunn is stepped too heavily by Achari.
circling with this is McAvoy. McAvoy banged it ahead. It's directed back high by Heinen and then taken by Maroon. That pinball off of Coyle and a swinging shot right in on goal and stopped by Binnington from the stick of Johansson. Shouldered by Chara around Paul O'Reilly, but it slipped through. McAvoy across. Oh, and one off that time was Corrali. Up to grabs O'Reilly and shot it one wide. May have blasted off the pad of Rats. Meanwhile, a tangle behind and the fans want a penalty and a shot. Ricocheted up high. Bergeron comes in and supplies that. Carlo walking it along. It came on back. His Pareko shot the save made by Rats. Going up full of the game from 50 feet. On to Schwartz, nicely dances free, and a shot is shrugged off there by Rask, and the rebound popped wide. Hit off the chest of Binnington.
Good idea there from Pastrnak, just get the puck to the net.
Here is Shen to the outside. Shen fed one in front, that poked away by Krug, and then he's able to get it on the recoil. But after it, cancels with Sandberg, able to step away as Johansson, and play it safely back to McAvoy. 4-10 gone, second period, and breaking on in now is Heinen.
Slipped on through and came all the way around near Kuhlman, closed off Gunnarsson, and it's fed on back but covered up by Shannon, then poked wide by Schwartz.
Off shift with Charlie McAvoy, real long.
Comes on back to Gunnarsson now, dropped it back in, they go to work again. Oh, and Shannon shot and a squat out of the air by Rask.
Wow, what a save. What a play by Schwartz to Shen and Tuukka Rask. Flash in the leather. Simple play, get it down low, get it out, and then there's the opportunity. Looked like it might have been going a little bit too high, but you never know, it may be wide, and off of Chara into the back of the net, but Rask gets that club out there.
Blue to his right dock, and he has the patience to just pump it to Carlo and clear.
Pareko got it on now for Maroon, and Pareko! And he is angry at his misfortune there, the net is dislodged. Behind Chara. Achari run into, but it is cleared not out. Done a shot, save made by Rask. Rebound! Is it in? It was behind for a moment, but did not go in.
There's that opportunity. Petrangelo, and there's McAvoy. With the quick stick in behind his goaltender, and then the puck disappears for a second. There you see, hung up in his gear. What a sequence. Just to have the patience there, Doc, and the poise to be able to get that puck out of midair. I mean, the athleticism, the hand-eye coordination, just amazing, and consider the stage we're on.
This is nudged ahead now, and here comes Kuhlman speeding up the ring. Kuhlman with a shot, and it's wide of the long side. It is drugged right back to Krejci again by Kuhlman. Fed on back to Krug. Hurried one, and that fought off there. Rebound! At the side of the net. The last minute and 15 seconds of the second period. Jostled there with McAvoy. Recovered to play it on through to David Krejci. Krejci able to step back ahead with it for the Bruins. Glides along and got it back for Krug and a save and a cover there by Binnington as driving to the net was Krejci and a crowd gathers. Drifting ahead with it. Watched there by Gunnarsson. Got it to Bergeron and a block there by Schwartz. Now it is Chara lobbing one around in front. Side of the net. Save made by Binnington with 1.5 to go on Pastrnak. DeBrusk is there. Kuhlman is there. And along now it is DeBrusk pointing it on back. Kept there by Carlo and his shot. Score! Carlo with a seeing eye bouncer from the right point that becomes the second goal of the game.
Doc, you touched on it. A fortunate bounce for the Boston Bruins. The forecheck, left part of your screen. Jake DeBrusk is going to go. The pressure is there, and there it goes off of the skate of the referee, Chris Rooney, and then DeBrusk. Look at this effort here. Gets it back to the point. We talked about the bouncing puck. Doc, remember in the second period what ends up happening? Look at this thing. It hits, it skips, and it goes inside the blocker into the back of the net.
Carson Kuhlman also gets to the front of the net, so that's a tough play for Jordan Binnington with that bouncing puck that you're talking about, Eddie. So, forecheck, slot area presence, bouncing puck, 2-0 lead.
That one grabbed by DeBrusk and
lifted back along by Krejci, gotten by Petrangelo, but then by Krejci again, and he steps in. Got it back over. Coleman is shot. He scores! Coleman with his brilliant goal, his first ever in the Stanley Cup playoffs to make it a 3-0 game. My goodness, what a ripper.
Petrangelo has it, turns it over. Krejci buys some time, and then Coleman fires it right by the blocker side of Jordan Binnington. And very noticeable since the first period that the Bruins are not turning down any opportunities to fire the puck at the net. You couldn't place that puck in the net any better.
And it was the NCAA MVP, the 2018 tournament for Minnesota Duluth, playing for Scotty Sandlin from Cloquet High School. Doc, Jamie Langenbrunner territory.
Strong shot by Perron is stopped by Rask. Here is Petrangelo. His shot went off Rask. Another shot. Oh, that one wouldn't go. Came on to the back of Gunnarsson.
Don't know if Tuukka Rask's pad was below. His pad was below the goal line when he made the save, Doc. Now, does this puck completely cross the goal line? Boy, on that overhead look there, Doc, really quickly. This puck has to be completely over the line. And yes, that puck looks like it was in, Doc. Right there. Looks like, yep, right there against the pad.
Sure enough. This will give the crowd the first sign of life for the night. Here we go.
Upon further video review, the puck completely crossed the line. We have a goal.
Around it comes for Vince Dunn. Reversed it around behind for Blake. And then it's taken away by Corelli. Right around his front. Pasternak. He scores! Pasternak. And it's 4-1.
Check by Corelli. Marchand with a beautiful pass, and then the patience of David Pastrnak goes top shelf on Jordan Binnington. Opens up that stick blade, looks like he's going to shoot it, and he waits and he pushes, causes separation, and buries it.
Gone down. Chara tried to feed it on. Marchand got it to the line, came back to Chara again, sailed down, and Zdeno Chara has made it 5-1.
Cruzo on Achari. Couple of, oh man. Bortuzzo with a couple of cross checks and then a left right to the head of Achari.
Sent him off immediately. 17 seconds to go. He couldn't serve a penalty entirely anyway.
There's one. There's two. And then right there. Aaron adding that energy to that Krejci line that Pierre was talking about. Huge goal, the third goal of the game. And the Bruins resilient themselves, Doc, here in game six.
And when it was a game, Tuukka Rask was enormous. Clinton with one last shot, snagged by Binnington. And the Bruins have forced a game seven by a score of 5-1.
Welcome to the Stanley Cup Final presented by Geico. And tonight, it's Game 7, the St. Louis Blues and the Boston Bruins.
The captains wear the C on their jersey. Alex Petrangelo is 29, born like most of the Blues in Canada. The 11th season, plays more than any skater remaining in these playoffs, about 26 minutes a game, a warrior. Zdeno Chara, 42, 6'9", tallest in history. 14th game seven, most in history, on a predominantly American team
native of Slovakia, probably playing with a broken jaw, unconfirmed until later tonight. One of these two men, by tradition, will be the first to receive the Stanley Cup at the end of the game tonight. And they will likely be the first two to shake hands after the game is over. But that is them. The fourth line against the fourth line to start the game. Grinding guys against grinding guys for the last of the best of seven. Alex Steen got it along there for Sundqvist, and Oscar Sundqvist fed it back up the boards. It is thrown toward the net, and that deflected away. It's done. Put one in that was blocked aside by Rask. Arbashev just back from being suspended for one game for a hit to the head. Brought back on now for a shot by John Morrissey.
Between the legs of Tuukka Rask.
Credit Craig Berube, Zach Sanford, slow start. Sammy Blay takes his place in the line, started it all with the big hit. Great job by Berube.
Well, ahead with this now comes DeBrusk. DeBrusk trying to pull his way in. It is rifled along by Perron, kept alive by Char, and spiked wide by DeBrusk. And dug out in another try by both Krejci and DeBrusk that would not go. Duels there, puck came loose. Held on, can be played now as Marchand was coming to the bench. It's thrown along by Schwartz. Schwartz able to pick it, dropped it on back now. Around it, that score! Petrangelo with 7.9 to go in the period.
It was such a long shift for the top lines of the Bruins. Brad Marchand wanted to make a line change. He got caught in no man's land. You see him right there. Then he steps up, goes to make a play. He leaves the ice surface. That leaves Petrangelo all alone to come in. And on the backhand, he goes up and over Tuukka Rask. 2-0 lead for the Blues.
What a move. Here's Marchand. His man goes here. And what does Marchand do, as Pierre touched on? He goes for the change. That leaves Petrangelo absolutely wide open. Forehand, backhand, over the shoulder of Tuukka Rask.
Meanwhile, nudged across by Marchand and walked right back ahead by Pasternak. Pasternak trying to work one, and a backhander is sealed up there by Binnington. He drops back defensively as the Blues are able to send it on back. It's taken on by Maroon. Maroon got it on over for play, and his shot was stopped by Rask, and play is stopped. The first shot on goal by the Blues this period, 5 minutes and 8 seconds in. Poked across for Corrali, but he is taken out of the play. So back ahead with it is Schwartz. He's got a man. It goes down. Puck in the air. Off the crossbar. Scrambling for it. What did it go? My goodness. Another try. And lurching there at the front of the net was Rask as it whistled by. Braden Schenn with one that went off the goal stick of Rask. Off the crossbar and stayed out. Tried to spin one in front, and Moore got it, then lost to Steen, and he got the blast with the shot! On the turning stick now, and Pullman, who races back in, takes his own pass, fires, and that one went wide. DeBrusk shot, and a save there by the kneeling Binnington. Dish bounced it off the boards behind. Gave it on over to Bullmeister, who was able to swing it to center, but Bergeron got it across. Marchand steps back in and shoots, and that glove and held by Binnington. Parayko there, fired it around. McAvoy poked it along. It's taken there and given behind by DeBrusk. Wraparound try from Kuhlman went wide. Krejci along to the outside. Pasternak. That one slipped on back, and Carlo there working it back. Marchand back to Carlo again. Carlo shot one, grabbed and held by Binnington. Two aside, and then it squibbed onto the corner. Petrangelo wound it around. Gunnarsson tried the other way off a glass support. Retrieved by Bergeron. Put off a stick and on goal. And another save made by Binnington. Johansson to the deep slot. Tried to jam one along, but in the way was Barbashev. Poked along to the outside, Heinen. Here's Heinen, a shot. Blocked away by Binnington. Rebound. Another shot by Heinen. Slowed down there by Rask and taken on by Torrey Krug. Michigan State product able to swagger his way on out. Gets it back up the wing. Kubishov! And it's snapped up and held by Binnington. Torrey tried to work it on three and could not. Closed off there by Gunnarsson. Puck to the back. Carlo! And that one kicked free in front by Shin. Gathered up by a Torrey save. Rebound in front. Some very good work out there, but meanwhile it is sailed on across and then that tipped further and on out to center. Final five presented by Rocket Mortgage, as stepping back in and being wedged to the corner with Perron, but he walked right out with it. Perron put it across, they score! Again, the Blues have made it 4-0, and it is Zach Sanford, the New England-born winger, that has made it 4-0.
Smiles all around for St. Louis. Watch this play by David Perron. Quick little stick handle, forehand, backhand, and Sanford, all he's got to do is throw those hands to the back of the net. No chance for Tuukka Rask. Beautiful play by Perron. The third time around as a member of the St. Louis Blues.
And the reaction from the end. 18,500 in Busch Stadium, raining earlier.
There's rain in the blue note right now at Busch Stadium, Doc.
Anxious to get on for a shift if they can get one. Krejci able to give it on across, and a shot by Grzelcyk, he scores! Matt Grzelcyk has made it 4-1.
Beautiful pass here from David Krejci. Grzelcyk. Puck was end over end, Doc, and ends up going. Crossbar and in. I think Binnington was expecting a fastball and ended up coming in more as a knuckler. Screened as well, but the Bruins still have some breath in the pod. Down three. 2:10 left.
Krejci able to come up with it now in the final 55. Krejci able to step by one, wanted to play it on the wing, and it winds up becoming an offside. Craig Berube had taken over in November and lost the first game 4-1 to Nashville. Gotten routed by the Jets 8-4. Arizona hammered them in December 6-1, and then came that New Year. And shortly after the New Year, the goalie came in, started his first NHL game. They had a defense that would wind up in double digits and shot blocking all the time. They wound up with an 11-game win streak. And things started to become sort of remarkable as they rose in the standings. Trickled back along, and it's taken by Krug in the last 35. Sent on back to Krejci, then Marchand, a shot that flew wide. Krug comes back in again, and this one popped wide of the glove hand of Binnington. In traffic, reaching for it, Krejci, and it pops on back to center, and Marchand yet again. Marchand spun it back in. Binnington able to kick it free and throw it up for this stick blade. It's rattled on around and Krug up with it, and the Blues at the bench are realizing that they are going to be champions. 10 seconds to go. The longest wait for a first title any team in this league has had. For the first time in their history, the St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions.